morning. I hope y'all can see me. I've already scrubbed my hands, and I'll scrub them again on camera when we start. I'm making my version of an eggless meatloaf that I make all the time, and I got it in patties, and all the directions and instructions will be below. And I've already mixed my dry ingredients, and all the ingredients are here, and they're mixed together. That's going to be below. But I'm going to go through everything with you. Let me wash my hands so you know I wash my hands. Because, as you know, a meatloaf is a hands-on situation. All right. I've done been in here prepping, but I wanted you to see that I did wash them. Although it's just, these are merely my recipes. It doesn't mean you have to come to my house and eat. It doesn't mean no one else is going to eat them. Sometimes they do, but they know I'm clean. My house is clean. Either way it goes. That being said, I'm making it pretty good because my husband will eat these for 2 or 3 days, and he requested me to make this, so I told him I would. I got 5 pounds of hamburger meat that I got out of the markdown bin for $2 and something. I think it was $2.60. And it was frozen, but I laid it out in the refrigerator last night, and now it's thawed out. Okay, 1 sleeve of original saltine crackers. Now, I've already crushed them, but I wanted you to see that you want them fine as you possibly could get. There's no eggs, so the crackers and other stuff is going to be your binder. Okay? Now, I got all the ingredients right here, which is parsley, a teaspoon of parsley, a teaspoon of garlic powder, a teaspoon of onion powder, a teaspoon of black pepper, a teaspoon of salt, a teaspoon of fresh garlic, a teaspoon of knorr beef bouillon, 2 teaspoons of Worcestershire sauce, 5 teaspoons of ketchup, and 5 teaspoons of water, and 1 envelope of onion soup mix. That's everything that's here. I want to, you kind of want to see, and you may have to add a little bit more water. You kind of want to see how this is going to, you want to get all that out because that's your flavor for your meatloaf. Oh, there's a little up there. You want these crackers, whenever they go into your meat, to be absolutely as wet as can be. And sometimes you have to add a few more drops of water or whatnot. You don't want your meatloaf to be absolutely soggy, but you want it to be pliable so that you can make your patties. I have a pan. I have my oven on 375. I have a pan lined right here ready for my patties. Okay. I think I am going to have to add a couple more drops. Add about, I don't know, 1 teaspoon and a half, 2 teaspoons. Okay. I have a 10-ounce bag right here of that I've already sweated down in the microwave with just a pinch of salt. It helps them get tender. It's celery, carrots, onions, and peppers. Okay? That's what I'm going to put in them because it makes them absolutely delicious. I'm going to go ahead and put that in there. I've already squeezed the liquid as best I could out of that. But there's going to be liquid in that. Nothing you can do about that. They smell good already. Okay, let's put this over here. All right. Now I'm going to pull this around. And you see that? We're just going to get rid of this. In my pan over, and I want you best I can. This has all got to be incorporated really well. Now I'm just going to start incorporating it. This is going to take a minute because it's a pretty good bit. Whenever I do make this, I always try to make extra because he likes it cold the next 2 or 3 days. He'll eat stuff. He'll come in. If he gets hungry, he'll come in and get him a sandwich where he's been working out down in, with the animals and stuff. So, and this is just the eggless version. There's 2 different kinds you can do with. I could have put at least 5 eggs in here and it would have been good. I could have put loaf bread in here with it. You can pretty much do it several different, this is just a different version because I have a meatloaf on my channel, and if you go back and look, it's on there. But you want to let this just squeeze all the way through. Oh, and ketchup. There's 5 tablespoons of ketchup in there. I forgot to say that. And it was on my list. It'll be down below. I'm sorry. Been moving and shaking this morning, cleaning out and moving my freezers and my washer and dryer. So, been going. And one of my lights above is blown. My friend is coming out today to fix them for me. So, I'm hoping it's light enough you can see. All right, I think that's good. Now, he likes for me to, I either do it 2 ways. I make a big giant one and slice it. This we're going to do patties. Okay? He likes the big patties so he can make sandwiches out of it. And I make them like a baseball size. And he just back and forth with it like that. Till it's about like that. And it does not hurt to, I'll show you whenever we get to that point, it doesn't hurt to stack them a little bit. See? Because they'll still cook as long as you patted them out good. They'll come out perfect. They'll separate. And this mixture freezes very well. If you feel like, well, that's way too much. We're not going to eat all that. I would not cook the meatloaf patties. I would go ahead and freeze the mixture and then thaw it out later because it may get a little liquidy. That way it's not so bad, but it freezes well. I've frozen it before. It's just like freezing hamburger meat. I'm gonna make that one a little bigger. Not quite as big as the other ones. Okay. Mixture itself smells really good. And you just bake it until you feel that it's firm enough that the way you would like it. And then you simply, I would remove them out of the oil as quickly as possible. Okay. It's a tight fit, but it's going to be all right. Should have used a bigger pan, I wasn't thinking. But it's fine. Don't worry about it. I usually get between 8 and maybe 8 and 10. But I'm making these pretty good size because I already know he's probably going to make sandwiches with most of them. That's what he likes. And you could do this in a jumbo muffin tin. I've done that. But the cleanup in it is pretty. You have to soak the muffin tin and all that. See the carrots and the celery and all in it. This is going to be I think I'm going to make a little one. I'll do a little one on the side for me a taste tester. How about that? I get all that hamburger meat off my fingers. Now, generally, you could, when if you put these in the thing, you could, whenever they get done, you could come back later, whenever the last 5 minutes, and add ketchup and stuff to them. I never do that because he usually, as I said, he usually grabs them and makes sandwiches with them or whatnot. So, I'm going to put this little bitty baby one on the side, and then that'll be my taste tester. Because I'm not going to eat any, I don't think. Very seldom eat very much I cook. He always eats it all. Make a little baby one and lay it right there on the side. Okay, let me wash my hands so I can put these in the oven. Take me just a second to get my water heated up. I don't want to touch everything with greasy hands. Hopefully you understand. Not through. Because I'm using 80-20 because that's what was marked down. But I always buy 80-20 anyway because it has more flavor. More fat, more flavor. It just, my suggestion would be to make sure you don't leave the meatloaf sitting in the grease when it's done. Because it's going to be quite a bit of grease off of it. Take them straight up and put them in another dish. All right. Here we go. All right. Gonna put these on an old trusty baking dish. And I'll see y'all back when they're done and we'll taste that little baby one. Okay, I am back and it took them 45 minutes to get to the doneness that they are. Now, I got my baby one. I don't remember if you heard me saying that I had a baby one I was going to put to the side for a taste test. But I would like for you to... Uh-oh, don't fall. Uh-oh. I want to show you a big one up close. Now, you can lay these out flat after you take them because there's a lot of grease. Drained the grease already. Went in the pig slop because we do have pigs. And, you could put ketchup on top, but I know he's going to put his pretty much on sandwiches, and he's going to add ketchup and mustard and onions and all that. So, but see, they're solid. So, now, we're going to cut this one so you can see it. See the inside? And I'm going to taste it. Let's see. Hmm. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Really, really good. I am going to put a little ketchup on mine and finish eating this one with a slice of bread. But I hope you will enjoy trying this and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. All the instructions and ingredients will be below. Thank you. I love you. Bye.